That's my old dog with her bad skin. Come to find out, she's had a terrible flea infestation. But she's on her meds now and is recovering. I wanted to talk about when I came back home when I was 26 years old. I came back to San Diego, back to all of California from back east where I lived for 2.5 years in Washington, D.C. And I came home, and my mother and my father were still living in this house. I came home in February. My dad was in pretty bad shape, but he was still alive and getting around a little bit. And it was months later in July, 5 months later, it would be if it was July, when he died. I came back from Washington, D.C. with a young woman who's about a month older than I am. I still know her. She's here in San Diego with her husband. And I met them, her and her husband, back in Washington, D.C. in 1975. And then we got together and they split up, and she and I came back to San Diego. She saw a picture of San Diego and decided she would come here. Now, I think she may have been here before, but maybe she was only in Los Angeles. Anyhow, she came here with me. She was 26 and I was 26. It was February of 1977. And just a few weeks before we left, we saw Jimmy Carter become president. It had been, as I say, 2.5 years since I went to Washington, D.C. Actually, 2 1/6. So I went there in November. No, 2 1/4. I went there in November of 74, and I stayed there until February of 77. Anyhow, that time when I was there in Washington, D.C., believe it or not, I did not go to New York even once. I didn't go any further north than Baltimore, and that's still a southern city. I did go to Richmond, Virginia, and I went to Charlottesville. My wife and my husband-in-law first lived together in Charlottesville. I call him my husband-in-law, but he's my ex-wife's ex-husband that she's married to again. He's my ex-wife's husband, but he was also her husband before, when they met me. So that's a long and difficult story, but I'll just tell you the facts. They're back together again and have been for 20 years now. No, longer than that. Yeah, they got back together 10 years after they split up. Yeah, she was with me for about 8 years. And then, so it might have been 9 years after they split up. But anyway, they're back together. And they're back together. And they've been together since years and years ago. And he's my son's stepfather. And there was another guy, also a boyfriend of my ex-wife, my son's mother. He was important too. He hung out with them all the time in Charlottesville, and later in San Diego he came to live here. And then he got cancer, and he actually lived with them until he died. they're interesting people. They hold on to the good old friends and hold on to them no matter what. I dearly love them. They've been wonderful parents to have for my son. They made up for almost all of my own shortcomings and failures. And they also gave me the freedom to do the good things I could do. So I'm thinking about them a lot because it's getting towards the last years of my life. These are probably the last years of my life. Maybe the last 10 years, maybe the last 1 year. But whatever it is, it doesn't matter because right now I'm thinking about it and being grateful that I've had life and that I've had the opportunity to do what I've always wanted to do, which is to make movies. When I was really young, I thought about making movies and TV, but then as I grew up, I found out that it's really a very complicated, involved process, and you have to do what everybody else says to do. And I've always been kind of selfish and a loner, and I just want to do what I want to do. So for many years, all I did was read and write by myself, sometimes read poetry to other people. But right now, as I'm living in the old house and feeling grateful to have a home here, I'm grateful to have a dog over there. She's been through some rough times, but I hope she'll be getting better now and will stick around with me for a while. I could have gone in the pool today. It's definitely warm enough. But I decided, no, I'd rather read. And so I sat inside there, is in the living room where I have my table, and that's where I read, and I write on the computer mostly. I do read some books. Here's a book I've been reading here. You maybe can see the title. Actually, that's not the title. It says, on the book, it says E equals MC squared. But the title is Einstein, His Life and Times. So I've been reading that book, which was one that my father had many years ago, and it used to be in this house. But I don't believe I ever read it before, even though it was, I think it was right on the bookcase in the bookshelf. Years and years ago, 50 years ago, 60 years ago. We moved into this house in 1959, in January. And parents bought it in 58, and then we moved in the last day of January, first month of 1959. And my mom lived here for almost 20 years, till after my dad had died, and well, and my dad lived here for 17 years until he died. And my mom got married a year later and moved out after that to live with her second husband, my stepfather. I was going on 28 when they got married. I was 26 when my dad died, and later on the next year I was 27 when, going on 28 when my mom remarried. And then that was when she moved out of here. My brother lived here for a few months longer by himself. And then he moved out, and my mom rented the house out from then on, from 1979 until 2021. This house is rented to other people. That was the 80s, the 90s, the aughts, and the teens. That was 42 years this house was rented to other people. I only really knew two of them, the last ones who were living here. Oh, they seem so young, even now they're starting to think about their retirement. There was a big part of me wished we could have sold the house to them, because they already enjoyed living here, and I liked the feeling I got from them. But they said they couldn't afford it. This house is too much. We put it up for sale in the year 2021, in the springtime. And after about 2 months, we got an offer which I wanted to accept, but my brother decided he didn't want to accept the offer. And since he and I own the house together, we need to agree. We had agreed to put it up for sale and list it and advertise it and to have the renters have to move out. We agreed to all of that. And he started telling me that he wanted to get enough money for this and that he wasn't going to give in to getting a price he thought was too low, and that he hoped I would not bully him into selling for a price that he thought was too low. And I thought to myself, I don't think I can bully him. I could be a bitch about it, and in some ways I have been a bitch about it. I wanted to sell, and I've never let him forget that I'm pissed at him. But as a Christian, I should forgive my brother. But it's hard for me even to forgive myself. So, there you are. Anyhow, I think I'm going to turn the camera off for a while. I've thought about something and said it already. Yeah. Back that way is the bedroom window. And then there's the living room window and the door into the dining room and the kitchen. This house is sort of stretched out from one end to the other. It's a long ranch house. It's been my home since I was 8 years old. At first I didn't like it, even though I loved it. I believe I loved it from the beginning because it's so beautiful. And it's right in the bottom of a canyon, and there's a creek, and there's big mountains all around us, and it's had all kinds of places for me to wander around on the hillsides and up and down the canyon, and it was just wonderful open place to grow up. But at the same time, I missed the house where we lived when I was a little thing. When I was three, we moved to a smaller house a mile or two away from here, in the same watershed and on a hillside above the same creek, but a mile or two away. And I missed that house because I was young and I was innocent, and then just about the time I realized there was no Santa Claus and that the world was not gonna just give me ice cream because I smiled, that's when we moved here, and I had to give up my friends in the neighborhood without having some sort of special way to get over to see them because it was a little bit too far for me to walk. Later on, when I got to riding bicycle, I could go over there, but it wasn't like it was when I was only 5 and 6 years old and we were all so young and innocent. Anyway, that was what I lost, you know. When we moved from that house and moved here, it was the same time when I had to grow up. So, I had a bit of a grudge against this house because it represented losing my perfect Garden of Eden. Yeah, how selfish can you be? I had this lovely place with a... Well, we didn't have the swimming pool until 10 years later, almost. Yeah, I was in high school when parents decided to build the swimming pool. It was a big investment, and they had to make sure they could afford it. They were both working, and the house had been mostly paid for, and they'd gotten some raises, and they decided to go ahead and invest. But first, They built an above ground pool out there. You see out there where that fence is over there? Over there, behind that fence, is a backyard. And that's where they built a pool above ground that cost way less than digging one in the ground costs. And they said, well, let's see if we like it. Let's see if we use it. And we did use it about half the year, even though it wasn't heated. From spring until fall, we'd go out in the backyard. And after a year, maybe two summers, their parents decided to go ahead and dig a pool right here. And they dug this pool in 1966, I think it was. The summer of between my sophomore and junior years in high school. Yep. At least I think that's when it was. It might have been in the springtime before summer. I think it was in the spring, yeah. Don't remember for sure, but I do remember roughly the year it was. I was in high school, and it was a big deal to have a pool. Oh, I went in it almost every day, all summer long. And then I got a little older, and I started going out and hanging out with friends. And when I was 19 and 20, I went and lived with other people. And oh, I forgot, I went away for a year to Los Angeles when I was 18. Yes, I did. I went away to UCLA and studied filmmaking and acting, and realized I don't like that business. It's too hard. I like acting, and I like making up stories and writing. And I wanted to make movies, but you have to do what everyone else tells you to do. And I've always been a stickler for doing things what I want to do. Even now, I'd rather live alone here with a dog and not have roommates. Mm-mm. Just sit here and read books and write things, poems and stories. And once in a while, now that it's the hot time of year, I get into the cement pond over there. I get into the cement pond, and I float around, and I float, and I kick my legs, and I exercise my arms, and I have a really, really wet moment. I think that bird wants a drink of water. Wouldn't it be nice to have a cool drink of water? Wouldn't it be nice to have a drink of water? Yeah. Somehow, it can be done.